Welcome to our channel Wi-Fi Gurukul, an online platform to update your knowledge about technology. Yes, we speak technology. Nowadays, we are so occupied and surrounded with internet and browsing. But are we actually browsing safe? Here, we will be discussing one generic topic, that is secure web browsing, and we will be discussing some of the secure web browsing tips. Okay, so Samriddhi, what is your tip about secure web browsing?
The first thing that comes to my mind is it won't happen to me mindset. I cannot be the target of hackers because I do not possess any critical information. No, but the truth is, hackers target people in groups and not individuals. Whenever a hack occurs, you can be the weak point of your organization or you can be a target of massive hacking attack.
Yes, I agree. Even a simple habit like providing same passwords for multiple accounts can lead to data theft. To avoid this, divide guarantees for various accounts and use different passwords for different accounts. Never reuse the same password, as using the same password makes it easier for the attacker to compromise the critical information. And yes, if possible, do adopt for two-step verification mechanisms.
Exactly, like people usually face difficulties in remembering multiple number of passwords. In that case, they can use encrypted password managers. A number of encrypted password managers are available in the market, and most importantly, these password managers are secure, easy to use, and all the user have to do is just remember a single password.
Another important thing that we need to discuss is users disregarding the updates. It is always advised to update your application and software time to time to reduce the software vulnerability. It is usually considered or seen as money-minting techniques, but it is actually not. The companies releases software updates and patches time to time to not only reduce the software vulnerabilities, but also improve the performance of the application.
Also, the users should always scan their files before downloading them. There are various softwares available in the market, as well as there are various extensions available to scan the files before downloading them. This is a better option, as once the malware is executed in the system, there is no limit to what damage it can cause.
One common question asked is, how to recognize a secure website? One identifier of a secure website is if the website starts with HTTPS rather than HTTP. The HTTPS websites transfer your requests over a secure network and your packets are encrypted. So if a hacker has hacked into a website, the information is not stolen because the data is encrypted.
Another important thing is don't fall for unsecure Wi-Fi connections. Attackers usually use wireless networks to steal someone's information over unprotected network. The best way to avoid this is to avoid using this kind of network altogether.
Do not download or believe any email or post. People, for some reason, tend to click on email sent to them directly without checking the authenticity of the mail. Rather, you should check the recipient as well as the link domain address. For instance, if it is sent by a company claiming that you have won certain packages or lottery, before you click on the link, make sure any member has taken part in the contest. You should understand that no gift or lotteries are distributed free of cost.
Do shop from reputed online shopping sites. You need to check the sites that you shop from. The very first step is to do the research of the website. You can use YouTube to view the reviews of the product that you are shopping for.
Alexander Kogan, a data scientist at Cambridge University, developed an app called This Is Your Digital Life. He provided the app to Cambridge Analytica. Cambridge Analytica, in turn, arranged a process of research in which several hundred thousand Facebook users used the app as a process of academic research. However, Facebook's design not only allowed the app to collect the personal information of the user using the app, but also the personal information of all the Facebook users in that person's Facebook social circle. In this way, Cambridge Analytica collected information from millions of users So, when you're online, your actions not only affect you, but also the people connected to you. Such that when you say you can't be hacked, it's not just your mistakes, but the people connected to you, whose single click may cost your personal data. If you want us to cover more such web browsing techniques or have any questions related to technology, let us know in the comment section below. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel.